summer in Florida. The snowbirds are back home, the kiddos are out of school, and it's now time to prepare for hurricane season. Hurricane season begins June 1st and it extends through November 30th, with the busiest months being August, September, and October. If you have not prepared yet, don't worry, there's still plenty of time, and we're gonna talk about that today. I am actually doing a two-part video series on hurricanes. Today, I'm discussing what to expect, how to prepare, what you can do to eliminate some fears and feel a little bit more confident going into hurricane season. The other video will be about insurance, wind, water, and what you need to keep you and your home safe throughout hurricane season. Now, I have linked some items in the description below that you may need and may want, and it's really easy to get prepared. Stick around because we're starting now. Hi everyone, I am Lisa McBride with Keller Williams Realty Select in Lakewood Ranch in Sarasota. I really appreciate your continuing to watch, and if you're new to my channel, welcome. Don't forget to subscribe and leave a comment below and let me know how I can be of help. Now let's talk about preparing for hurricane season. First though, I want everyone to know, yes, Florida can get hit by hurricanes. However, we do not experience hurricanes every year. And although tropical storms are definitely possible, the reality of going through a hurricane every year is very, very slim. And Sarasota has not had a direct hit in decades. And I'm not saying that it can't, it's just not as often as you may think. So this is the case of being prepared and not panicking. This will consist of supplies and also evacuation if needed. Let's talk a little bit about evacuation. If you were to evacuate, do you know what the routes are? Do you know where you would go if you were happen to decide to evacuate? Do you have pets and loved ones that you need to consider in this decision-making process? And what category of a hurricane would make you want to leave town? Because remember, a Category 1 storm is completely different than a Category 3, 4, or 5. And remember, you're going to have many days in advance to go, so you kind of need to start a plan. The one thing to keep in mind with a hurricane is the amount of time and prep time that you prepare. We start hearing about hurricanes and the disturbance out in the ocean, and then hear about the cone of uncertainty, and the next thing you know, you start hearing about the spaghetti lines, and there is so much speculation about where it's gonna land and what the strengths. Storms definitely have a mind of their own, and they can shift and change direction swiftly, and so sometimes it's hard to make a really quick decision or know which way to go. Having a plan is one thing, but also having the supplies needed if you are staying is really, really important. It's really quite easy and normal to prepare a kit for a hurricane. And most of the items you can just get on Amazon or your local hardware store. As I said, there's a number of links below that will help you fill your hurricane bin so you don't ever have to worry about it again. To start with, to assemble your kit, just get an airtight plastic bag or container that is easy to move around. Now, the number one thing that you want to have, if you have nothing else, is a very good and large flashlight. I recommend getting a large, durable one. And along with flashlights, don't forget to get the batteries, because you just don't know how long you may be using those flashlights. The second item that I highly recommend is a weather radio. These are great options, and you can find that some of these weather radios also come with a flashlight. So dual purposes, what better way to get something that you really need? The next item is a first aid kit, which is kind of a given. Also, food, at least 3 days of non-perishable items, water, 1 gallon per person per day, and you want to have enough for 5 days because you just don't know how long you may be without water. And remember, water isn't just about drinking, it's about sanitation as well. One quick tip here is, if we really are in a severe threat and the storm is coming our way, that it's recommended to fill up your bathtub with water. Now, this is great to use for sanitation purposes, water for pets, you know, some cleaning. Fill up anything you can that will store water. Now, something that most people don't talk about but is really, really great to have is a battery-operated fan. If you lose electricity for even 24 hours, I am telling you that you will want to have some air movement in your home. And the only way to to create that is with a battery-operated fan. Make sure you have a waterproof document bag to put all your important papers in. Have lots of hand sanitizer, which I think we probably all have at this point. It's really advantageous to have a wireless charger and power bank for keeping those cell phones charged. You don't want to see yourself just sitting out in your car trying to charge your phone. Now, another item is a portable generator. There's many shapes and sizes of generators. Although many may not be able to completely cool your home the entire time, it is capable many times of keeping the refrigerator running and create a bit of a reprieve from the extreme heat. So I highly recommend checking out some different options when it comes to generators. A few other items that you may want is some moist toilets, plastic sheeting and duct tape in case you do have to cover something, a manual can opener for the canned goods. Now, all of these items fit really neatly inside of a huge Tupperware bin, and you can just mark it with hurricane preparedness. Now, you could live here 10 years and never use anything in this kit, or you may be like me, where the first year I'm in town and a major hurricane hits. So I can definitely tell you that I learned a lot through that first hurricane, and being prepared is the way to go because I knew nothing about hurricanes during that first one. And now I can tell you I'm really prepared. As I mentioned, I do have two videos regarding hurricanes, and the next one is on hurricane insurance and being prepared. If you have questions about hurricanes in Florida or anything that I've mentioned, please let me know how I can help. I mentioned I'm not here to try to scare anyone. I really just want to make sure that you're prepared because we do live in Florida. As always, I really appreciate you watching, and until next time, take care.